Morning, guys. I'm going to get warmed up in about 30 seconds, and we'll get after it. Remember, if you don't have a kettlebell, that's fine. You'll do a dumbbell. I'll tell you what to do with the dumbbell as we get going. And we'll get loose and have some fun and take it from there. All right, we'll start in about 30 seconds.
Oh, right today, Kim. Right.
Yeah. Right. Is that you? No, actually, it's really cold. I've been cleaning out my stuff, and I know I have all these things that are not a little pile. Very pretty.
I like it.
All right, guys, let's head to the floor on your hands and knees. Spread those knees wider than your hips. Sit back. Bring those hips forward. Sit back. Bring those hips forward. Nice and easy. You just rolled out of bed. Get those hips loose, that back loosened up. Take one leg, kick it out to the side. Toe straight ahead, sit back. Yeah. Oh, yeah, feel that stretch, baby. Ooh. Ooh. See, again, I think them fellas are scared of me. I don't know what's going on. Man, the Swiss sides, I always get my girls with me. Fellas, they can't hang. Colin and Sean. I don't know.
Yeah, why is that?
They can't keep up with you and Kelly, Kim.
Yeah. Colin's watching from home.
Ah, hi, Colin. Colin's at home. Hey, bring that leg in. Straighten out one leg. Cross it over. Sit back into that bent leg. Same side knee and elbow. Together. Opposite arm. Out straight. Reach out. Can grab it to the floor, pull that arm out a little bit more. And come up, switch to the other side. And come back up to your hands and knees. Let's round your back, flatten your back. Round your back, flatten your back.
Kim, the color for today was royal blue. I can get the memo.
And come up to that high plank, drive that knee forward. Step on that pinky, rotate to that front leg, come down, step back, and let's switch. Now this time, rotate away from the front leg. Let that back foot rotate as you rotate. That back foot rotate as you rotate. And stay that high plank. Let's go into a downward dog.
Drive those heels to the floor.
Come back down to a high plank.
Kiki says, I'm in a parking lot full of worms. I definitely have to do a standing version.
Do it off off your car. Hey, keep those legs locked out. Walk those feet up. When you get there, push those knees open. Let's squat down. Let's rock side to side. Lift that butt up. Drop the head. Pull that butt back down, rock side to side. Try to have your chest up, shoulders pulled back. Good squat position. Lift that butt back up, slowly stand up, and let's spread our feet. Toes straight ahead, shift your weight, left to right. If you can, try to get a little bit lower. Use your hands on the ground if you have to. Beautiful weather we're having this morning, huh?
Oh my God. Can't take it anymore.
Let's stand up. Shake it out. And grab that ankle. Pull it back. Reach. Reach. Nice and easy. can. And sit back, kick that leg out, reach down, come up, reach down, come up. And feet together, knees together. Hips are hinged back like so. Palms are up. Rotate up, come down. Rotate up. And from that position, let's rotate, pivot, nice and loose. And stand all the way up, continue to pivot and rotate, but up tall. Let that back foot pivot as you turn those hips. Take that pressure off your knee from when you rotate. Let the arms just go. And shoulder rolls forward. And backwards. And neck rolls. Yeah. Go hips. Bring them around. Reverse directions. Yeah. Have some fun this morning. And bring those knees together. Bend again. And rotate the knees. Snap, crack, and pop. Pedals over here cracking. Knees, ankles, everything. And reverse. And stand up. Ankle. Reverse.
Watching.
Chasing, you talk calm or something. And switch.
He says we're channeling Steve Magnelli, yes.
And reverse.
And Dennis, you're cracking a lot too, I feel you.
And pull that knee up, toe up, knee up.
Colin.
Toe up, knee up.
Representing.
Okay, pull that leg up. Pull that leg up.
Chasing is exercising.
Nice, Chasing. And let's go. High knees. Give us about 10 seconds. And hops in place. Side to side. Back to hops in place. Back to jacks. Oh, we didn't do jacks. We're doing jacks now. And high knees last time, 10 seconds. Three, two, and relax. Shake it out. Grab some water. I'll explain our first round while you're resting. Let's get a roll call so I see who I'm talking to. Chime in, say good morning, say hello, so I know who's here with us. My man, my man. All right, guys, so This first round, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna do swings, Tabata style. So you're gonna do 20 seconds of swings, I'm gonna give you a 10 second break. We're gonna do that 8 times, all right? You choose what kind of swings you'd like. If you're still learning how to do the swing and you have a kettlebell, you're gonna do two-handed swings, okay? If you have a dumbbell, you're gonna do a dumbbell swing. That looks like so, hips are back, arm is straight. Bring it overhead, pull it down, come back, you can switch hands, bring it up, pull it down, and back. Okay? So you choose. I'm gonna go in 5 seconds. 3, 2, and let's go. Hips back, stand up tall, breathe. So you should either be doing what Heather's doing over here, or what Kim's doing over here, or me. 3, 2, set it down, nice and easy. Shake it out. If you have multiple sets of bells, start with your light bell first. Go in 3, 2, and go. Breathe out. 10 seconds. Stay relaxed up top. Don't shrug your shoulders. 3, 2, set it down. That's 2 down. As you start to get loosened up, the blood stops flowing. Try to increase your bell size. And let's go. Squeeze that butt hard at the top. Keep those feet solid and planted on the ground. 3, 2, and relax. Going in 5, 3, 2, and pick it up, let's go. Job. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and down. Going in 5, 3, 2, and go. Breathe it out, stay relaxed. 3, 2, set it down. Going in 10. Yes. And let's go. Take it. Breathe. Aggressive with your hips. Stand up tall. And down, 2 to go, 2 to go. All right. Keep drinking your water. No rush. Next round, we're doing one arm row. Eight right or eight left. You choose, you want to use a kettlebell or a dumbbell. Up to you. Then, you're going to hit the deck. Try to give me eight walking push-ups. Eight. So come down, come up, switch sides, come down, come up. Eight. If that doesn't work for you, go to your knees and do your push-ups, walking side to side, or go to your knees on the floor and do push-ups, or just give me regular push-ups. Cool? You have eight of those. Kiki, if the ground's wet, muddy, do it off your car. Or give me a chest press. And then we're gonna lay on our backs and do a runner's crunch. So you're gonna sit up, start with your feet on the ground, pull one leg in, come down, pull one leg in. If you got it, keep your feet off the ground, up and down. You have 20, 20. All right? Gonna go 15 seconds with our one-arm rows. One-arm rows. Gonna repeat this round for 5 minutes. Let me get a clock before you guys get upset with me. Kim didn't want to share a stopwatch. All right, you ready? 3, 2, and let's go. Stagger your feet and pull up. You got eight. Make sure you're bent over so you're pulling into your back, not your neck. Don't be up here. Get down. Rest that arm on your thigh. Eight rows per side. Then set the bell down. You can do walking push-ups from your knees like Heather, or off your knees like Kim. Or if you have to, give me regular push-ups off your knees or on your knees. Your choice. You have eight. Eight of those. Then you're going into that runner's crunch. On your back. Sit up. Pull it in. You have 16. Once you complete those 16, hop back up, back to your rows. Eight right, eight left. If you have a very light weight, go slow. So pull the weight up, come down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pull it up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you have a light weight, that's what I want you to do. Go at a pace that works for you. After your rows, you're back to your push-up. Let's go for it. And then you're back on your back. Runner's crunch. So you can find the rhythm, keeping your feet off the ground. Keep it going. We're at the halfway mark. Going back to your rows. Another way to make your rows more challenging is pause at the top. So if you have a light weight, you don't want to go down slow, hold it at the top for 2 to 3 seconds. Come down, hold, 1, 2, and back down. Make sure when you row, squeeze underneath that armpit. That big muscle in your back is called your lat. Squeeze that area underneath your armpit. Minute 30 seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, time. Grab a sip of water, guys. Let that heart rate come down a little bit. We'll be back. 2 and 2. You get back.
Push up masses. On Friday.
Check your balling points. Make sure your technique is right for your push ups. If you're a superhero taking the next superhero program and you're watching this, we sent you guys an email. Make sure you check it. Reach out to me. All right.
Carly said she's missing your playlist.
Oh, Carly. I'll make sure to add that next time, baby. Sorry. All right. Next round, you're going to do a long cycle clean. Long cycle clean. So, you'll come through, come up, rack it in, swing, rack it in. You're going to do 5 right, 5 left. Long cycle cleans do not work for you today. Grab your dumbbell. You'll do a dumbbell clean. Hinge back, touch the floor, tuck that elbow under, come back down, tuck that elbow under. 5 and 5. Then, we're going to go into a suitcase deadlift. Hinge back, weights by your side. Sit back, come up, sit back, come up. 5 and 5, if you don't have a kettlebell, just hold the dumbbell by your side. Sit back, come up, sit back, come up. Gonna go in less than 30 seconds. That's 5 and 5 as well. For those suitcase deadlifts, use your heaviest weight you got. If you want, grab a backpack and fill it up with weight. Or grab some object that's heavy around your house. All right? In 5 seconds, we're gonna start with our long cycle cleans. Going in 3, 2, and 1, let's go. Long cycle clean, hips back. Tuck it in, breathe. Keep the weight high in your groin. 5 right, then we'll go 5 left. Hand-to-hand switch, after you get 5, bring it in. Go with the bell. Have you done 5 and 5? Suitcase deadlift. Hinge back. Stand up. Stand up. No, you do not have to go all the way to the floor, but if you have the flexibility to get down there with good form, touch the floor. Don't let the weight yank you as you go down. Sit straight back. Two days together, five and back eight from. So just two drills around. Just two. Good job, baby. Good job. Keep rolling. Keep the belt close. Have a loose grip so the belt can move around. Remember, keep the belt close. Don't let it get away from you. When you come up, you have to reel it in. And when you reel it in from up there, that's when the belt bangs you. Keep it tight. Elbow stays tight to the body. Come up, thumb to the chest, back, thumb to the chest. We have one somewhere. Have one more. You're at the halfway mark. If you have heavier weights and you're comfortable with them, go to them now if you haven't been using them. Two minutes left in this round. Challenge yourself appropriately. If you have to stop and breathe, stop and breathe. Yeah. Woo, woo! Just over a minute to go.
Yay!
You have to stop, shake it out, reset yourself, and get right back to work. Less than a minute. So hopefully we can get outside. 30 seconds left. 30 seconds left. Use your hips. Slow your pace down if you're getting tired. Stay with me. Don't quit early. Three, two, and down. Good job. Break. Grab some water. You got a minute break here. How everybody doing today? Have a good week? Everything good? If you're out there and you haven't got equipment yet, please reach out to us. It is slim pickings, but we got a couple things left. 30 seconds, we're gonna stop back up. Don't worry, I'll tell you what you got. Be simple. In 10 seconds, we're going into jumping jacks. Very simple. You'll do it for one straight minute. 3, 2, and go. Huh? Yeah.
Yes, Ben.
Yes, Ben, we got greens, baby. That's 10 seconds. Keep going. Try to shift gears, go a little bit faster. Keep pace with us. Well, she said, keep pace with Kim. 20 seconds to go. Shift gears faster. Gotta get more than 10 reps in 10 seconds. 10 seconds to go. Let's go. All out. Faster. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and relax. Good job. Grab some water. While you're resting, I'll tell you what you got next. We're gonna go figure eight to a hold. Figure eight to a hold. Okay? So, you're gonna have a sphere in the palm of your hand like so. Grab the handle closer to your body. The weight goes in the middle. Switch hands, bring it up. Switch sides. Keep your hands above your knees. I'm passing it. One side to the other, one side to the other. Okay? We'll do that for 10. If you do not have a kettlebell, do figure eights. You're gonna go back to that one arm swing you did earlier. Coming up, you're gonna do 5 and 5. Second drill, it's gonna be a windmill. So the weight is up top, kettlebell or dumbbell. Turn your feet away, drive your hip back. Okay, feel your way down, try to touch the floor, and drive up. That's an easy movement for you. Hand behind your back and do it. If having weight overhead freaks you out, put it in your bottom hand, empty hand up top, feel down, and come up. You have that 5 and 5 as well. Okay, only go down as far as you can that you feel comfortable with. Remember, if you can't do it up top, do it in the bottom hand. Focus on your technique on that one. That's a slow drill. Take your time on that. Your figure eights is a fast drill. Okay? Just those two drills. Just those two drills. I'm gonna go in 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, and let's go. Figure eight to a hold. Touch the bell. Swing through. Bring it up. If you're not gonna do figure eights, do dumbbell swings like Heather. 5 and 5. Keep your hands above your knees. Don't let it drift to the floor. The closer you go to the floor, the more rounded your back will be. You want to keep it flat. Okay? You have 10. Once you're done with those 10, go right into your windmill like Kim. Have that back leg lock out, drive into your hip, front leg is bent. Squeeze underneath your armpits, eyes stay on the kettlebell overhead. Taking your time. Reach towards the ground, move slowly. If you can't go to the floor, that's fine. Inch your way down each rep. Try to go a little bit further each time. If up top doesn't work, go in your bottom hand, like Heather. Everything is the same. I still want you looking at your top hand. Drive that hip out. All right?
I feel the IT man on this side.
Yeah, I feel everything. Woo! Body's tight. Remember, don't rush, don't rush. Move your way through the pattern. Nice and easy. slowly. This is my bad side for me, so I gotta go a little bit slower, reaching down. This is my shoulder surgery side. On this side, so this side of my body's a little messed up. Ah. Keep it up. Make sure you're breathing through. If you want to make your feet range harder, try to go faster. Tap and go. Tap and go. Tap and go. Tap and go. Good job, Kim. Get that hand behind your back if you can. Good. Go right into those figure eights like a flow drill. One drill to the other. Good job. Great job, ladies. 2 minutes, guys. 2 minutes. Minute 30 to go. Again, you want to challenge yourself more on your figure eights. Turn it into a bottoms up or gunslinger. Get that grip. Tight, tight, keep that elbow tight. Less than a minute, baby. Everybody holding up, we good. Hopefully you had your coffee. Maybe you have a coffee right now, who knows? Just don't let weights fly when you get overexcited. Not at the TV or your phone or laptop, whatever you're looking at. In 20 seconds, we're gonna get back to work. We're gonna go back to those jumping jacks for a minute. If jumping jacks don't work for you, you can do high knees instead. Or march instead if his knees are sensitive this morning. All right, ready? 3, 2, and go.
Ben says red ain't just the color of my shirt.
My dog. Yeah. Try to touch your hands at the top. Get that big range of motion. Don't get lazy in the knees. Touch. Shift gears a little bit faster. Count how many you do in 10 seconds. Faster. Try to beat those last 10 seconds. 5 seconds, let's go. Finish it off. 5 seconds. 3, 2, time. Water. Woo! Yeah. All right. So last round coming up. It'll be a slight doozy, which will be all right. Promise. A little challenge round for you. Okay.
Wait. Lori says, "Have any respect for the bridges on the sports rock." Yes, Lori.
I don't know anything about it, but I can imagine. All right, so our last round, here's the deal. Adjust your weight accordingly to where you're at and how you feel right now, okay? If you want to push yourself, start with a heavier weight, and then as the reps go up, you go to a lighter weight, okay? I'm gonna do a ladder. It's gonna suck a little bit. You're gonna do a squat to a press. 2 right, 2 left. Then you're gonna go 4 right, 4 left. 6, 6, 8, 8, 10, 10. Squat and press. Okay? You can start with your heavier weight for the low reps and then decrease your weight if you have to as the reps go up. If you can maintain the weight you have, stay with that weight. Okay? See how fast you can get this done in.
Chef Nick says pizza for everyone. That's what we're
doing. All right. This clock is you on your own, okay? At your pace, going through your own challenge, starting with 2 right, 2 left, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1. Dumbbell or kettlebell, squat, and press. You see, I'm delaying it, right? All right.
Just ladder up, Janice wants to go.
Yes, just ladder up, Janice. Just ladder up to 10. All right, enjoy it. All right, just laddering up to 10. Once you hit 10, we can stop. Woo! All right? Ready? 3, 2, grab your bell, your weight, bracket, squat down, drive up, squat down, drive up. That's 2. You can go right to the other side or set it down if you have to. Clean it up on the other side. 1, 2. Now you got 4. Ha!
Kerry.
Oh, trying.
I'm going easy.
That's 4. Poor side. Stop for a second if you have to. Regroup. Next up will be 6. And 6. When you're ready, grab your weight, get right to it. I'm delaying. All right, ready for me. You have to use that other hand. You can.
If you have a light weight, try to keep going.
You know what she said?
I have a light weight.
Thank you. Good job out there, guys. Good job, brother. I got one more set. 10 and 10.
I'd say thank you, but I can't talk. Good job, Chase. Finish strong, guys. Don't quit on yourself. Don't start that negative self-talk. Kerry's description of this will suck was accurate.
I told you. All right, you're going to go to your hands and knees. Hopefully you're done. If not, keep going. Don't quit. All right, you're going to spread your knees wider than your hips. Sit back, hang out there for a minute. Then take that right arm, rotate under you, to your left,
flip to your left.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You're welcome, Carly.
Thank you, Carly.
And switch. And come up. Let's go back to our pigeon stretch like we do in the beginning. Straighten it out, cross it over, sit back. Make sure you drink lots of water today. If you haven't been drinking your water, try to aim for a gallon a day. A gallon of water a day. Make that a habit of yours. Switch sides.
Carly,
Joe, Joe! Silva! My man! And come up. Round your back. Tuck your chin in your chest. Flatten it out. And back up. And one more time. And come up to that high plank position. Leg locked out, lock those feet up to your hands as high as you can. Slowly stand up, squat down, push those knees open. You guys will get the schedule for the upcoming week tomorrow, so be on the lookout for that. Feel free to share any of these workouts with your friends, family, add your kids if you like. And slowly stand up. Just change the tool. Cross your arm in the front, apply a little bit of pressure to your elbow. And shake it out, switch. There goes on, just tuck your chin in your chest, both hands behind your head, and pull down. Right hand to the left side of your head, turn your chin to your right armpit, pull down. And switch. Shake it out. Just stand there for a minute. Put your hand at your belly button, close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. Blow it out. Try to relax. Deep breath in. Blow it out. Let the heart rate come down. Deep breath in. Blow it out. Relax. Hang out there. About 31 seconds. I know you may feel awkward doing this. It's good for your mind, good for your body. We have the yin and yang. We push hard, we go hard. We also got to remember, we got to chill out, refocus. Good. Shake those arms and legs out. Come on up to the screen, your phone, laptop, wherever you are. Hey, great job today. Hopefully you guys got after it. My two ladies, kill us, kill us. All right, if you need anything, guys, please reach out to us. We got your back. We'll help you however we can. Email. If you call the gym, leave a message. If we're not here, we'll check it the next day, okay? But please reach out to us. Communicate. We are here for you. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. All right? Have an amazing day. Hopefully we'll see you tomorrow for yoga at 10 a.m. with... Nope, sorry, scratch. That's next week. My fault. That's my fault. You're with Kim tomorrow doing the outside workout. Okay? We'll explain all that tomorrow. But if you want to be outside, you'll be outside. Just bring your phone. You can search this on your phone. If you're going to be inside, we'll tell you what to do inside. You could also go to the app. All right? If you open up the app, it'll say 212 Live Workouts. Click on that, and that will take you to the 212 page. Find the playlist. It says 212 Live Workouts, and we'll be right there, okay? But we'll fill you in for that tomorrow. All right, guys, bring it on in. Let's go. 212 on three. One, two, three.
212.
Yeah, baby. Have a great day, guys. Love you.